political force in this town, Kristen Wong-Tan. Come on up, Kristen. When asked if she is a female politician she admires, it could be Libby Davies. Who knows from Libby Davies? Thank you. Libby Davies is absolutely fearless. I love her. Who am I looking at? Over here? So, the Toronto Women's City Alliance was founded in 2004 by a diverse group of women who all had one common concern, that the voices of women and girls was disappearing from the city's agenda. The status of women's committee had stopped meeting in years, and so now at City Hall, who speaks for women and girls? You might be asking, aren't women already equal? Isn't Toronto already a women-friendly city? The answer is not simple, a yes or a no. We have to look beneath the surface. For example, when we put the gender equity lens onto a particular subject such as poverty, and we take a look at children in poverty, we now realize that it's not children who are poor, it's their low-income women of color mothers who are poor. Women come from all walks of life and have intersectional identities. Yet the reality for women is that we face greater violence, poverty, homelessness, poor diet, unemployment, precarious work, discrimination, inefficient daycare, unaffordable, inaccessible public transportation. Try taking a baby stroller onto the crowded bus or subway, and you'll get my point. Toronto is already getting ready to host the World Pride and to host the Pan Am Games. The world is coming to Toronto, and we are getting ready. In fact, we're building new subways, new homes, new shiny buildings, and new roads. How much of this economic stimulation is actually going to benefit women? How much of this is going to create green, good jobs? Is Toronto really ready for our close-up? Let's find out what women in Toronto... how women in Toronto compare to others living in Madrid, Zurich, Vienna, Barcelona, London, San Francisco, or even Seoul, Korea. These are just a few of the cities, large or small, that have seen the benefits of a women's equality office. How can Toronto declare itself a world-class city when more than half of its population is still being marginalized? These cities have dedicated staff and resources to make sure that women's issues do not disappear from the urban agenda. They have been able to increase the employment rates for women, make transit safer and more accessible, and to adapt policies to reduce the barriers for women's participation in municipal programs. Women in Toronto are not faring well. We only make 71 cents on the male dollar, and it gets worse. 56 cents on the male dollar if you're an Aboriginal woman. Women in Toronto make up 52% of the population, and yet only 11% of the elected officials. Middle-class women, or even affluent women, are only one man away from poverty. We look back into the archives of Women Plan Toronto to see where women, what women were talking about 30 years ago, and pretty much they're talking about the same things. So what would a Toronto Women's Equality Office do in Toronto? It would create a city where everyone feels safe to walk. We can all afford to buy a home to live in. We can live in nice housing. Our children will be cared for when needed, and we can breathe clean air. And we can get around the city easily and affordably. In our current project, we conducted focus groups with a broad range of women across the city and talked to them about their experiences with city services. We asked them to draw what a friendly woman city would look like. These are some of these images. I get a break. So the Toronto Women's City Alliance is trying to make this a reality. We believe that to achieve a women-friendly Toronto, we need to do what other cities have already done and to establish a Women's Equality Office, a publicly funded department at the city who will take into account women's lived experiences and its budgeting, its planning, and its policy making. So how can we make this happen? Well, we can all make this happen. Quite honestly, go talk to your city councilors. Talk to the mayoral candidates. We have a couple of them here tonight. Make sure that they know that you want to see a Women's Equality Office at City Hall. They will no doubt tell you it's a good idea, but the city is broke. To that, you tell them women's equality is the biggest bang for their buck. We will start spending money differently. That's right. We will start spending money differently based on the user requirements of women and girls through gender budgeting. We won't have to go to court to fight over hockey time, ice time for hockey. Yeah. When women have equality, we are able to work, pay our taxes, take better care of ourselves and our families. Who doesn't want that? 2010 is our year. Join us in our efforts. Let's not squander the opportunity. Thank you very much.